very warm welcome and good evening, and thank you from our hearts. It's a very special space that we're co-creating here, this calm collective, and it really is a co-creation. We're up to 116 people, and it just always kind of keeps growing each week with this sense of feeling that when we come together with our heartfelt intention, and we know that the science is backing up what those in the mystic traditions have always known, that when we gather with pure intention for something that is altruistic, that it makes a difference. It impacts the lives and the way of the world. So this is us, all of us, the Calm Collective. If you're here for the first time tonight, very warm welcome. And if you're returning, it's great to have you back. Now tonight, to lead us off, the way that we begin is we have a special guest. It's usually someone who's a long-term meditator or faith leader. And this week, we have with us the Venerable Chikwang Sunim. And she was ordained a Buddhist nun for 40 years, having initially trained for 20 years in South Korean monasteries. She has founded several Buddhist organizations. She's currently the Abbess of the Seon Centre in Kinglake, Victoria. Sunim has been chair of the Australian Sangha Association and the Buddhist Council of Victoria, and is very active in interfaith dialogue. She continues to teach meditation and Buddhist studies in Australia and internationally. She offers retreats in Australia and abroad, and is regularly invited to be a guest speaker at conferences, workshops, and temples. So that's the formal introduction, and I've been watching some of her videos, and I can say I love her wisdom, very direct, practical, and heartfelt wisdom, and her overriding sense of peace. So very, very warm welcome, Sunim.
So tonight, I'm going to give a little... just to talk about making tea as a practice that can nurture many wholesome and contemplative states of mind. So just as we settle into meditation and we simply listen, I would like you to reflect on my words. In the first verse, I use the pun of tea, followed by humanity in a teacup. Two verses I wrote just today, actually. Tonight. Reflectivity, serenity, and clarity. Potentiality, universality, and possibility. Equality, capability, and solidarity. Hospitality, confidentiality, immunity. Tranquility, fragility, purity, sustainability, generosity enables humanity. In our shared collective quiet, let me point to the simple essence of making and drinking tea. The sound of tea falling into a teacup. Can you hear it? It fills space and time with the fragrance of the present. A cupped hand gently embraces this tiny warm vessel, which has the world within it, including you. In a quieter, reflective moment, the breath pauses in stillness. then it expands beyond shape, form, and color to feel the universal warmth, encase and embody potential so as to savor the taste of the spring sweet dew. Such fulfillment brings me home to ponder on life's humanity in a cup of tea with you.
How beautiful. Thank you, Sunim, for that inspiration. Interesting how many very special words complete with the T-Y, tea. Thank you. So I'm going to draw from something you said in that we can all hold a particular intention and inspiration as we go into the next 10 minutes. And I love this idea that everything could be in a cup of tea, that the whole world, and it's so simple. And, you know, there's such a saying that every problem can be solved over a cup of tea. So it's this very heartwarming, very round the kitchen table that we're all part of it. So this vision and this intention that the whole world is in this cup of tea, which is something that connects us all. So for the next 10 minutes, thank you very much for that inspiration, Sunim. For the next 10 minutes, this will be our focus. If you like to visualize that we're all sitting around a big table with a cup of tea and what that means for our humanity. wonderful. I had very much a sense of this relaxed, unified, beautiful coming together. Thank you so much, Sunim, for that contribution. Thank you all very much. And I just want to say that it's really beautiful to know that the person who launched this collective with us, the wonderful Justin Langer, the great cricketer, he's at his lunchtime in Abu Dhabi and he's still joining us. So it's really great to know that you're with us, Justin. Thank you. And I also would like to welcome back Asha Pakman and the team, Lisa Ford and Karen Stone from Meditation Australia. And I suspect that there are a lot of new collective members or those who might become collective members who have come from Meditation Australia due to the beautiful invitation that Karen sent out this week. So also Rob Moody is joining us as one of our featured supporters. And if you would like to become a member and you're not of this collective and invite others to join each Sunday, 9 till usually it finishes about 9:20. So there we are. Thanks again. Next week we've got the joyful and wise Bhakta Das, who is head of the Faith Communities Council of Victoria, and he's going to give us a couple of minutes of inspiration. Once again, Sunim, thank you very much for being with us. And why don't we just now open our, go to gallery view, open our cameras and just see the wonderful faces and beings who are joining this incredible, relaxed circle. And I see Stephanie, you're here all the way from Darwin now. Lovely to see you, Stephanie Dowry. Wonderful. Everyone have a great week. And every time you have a cup of tea this week, it will be full of inspiration and peace. Hope to see you next week too. Lots of love. Bye-bye.